Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. So my name is Pola and today I'm going to be showing you guys how I like to draw bodies. So obviously you guys don't have to follow me, and I actually prefer if you guys don't exactly copy me, because this is my way of how I draw bodies, but I'm just showing you guys in this video. So we are starting off with female bodies. So I like to first off draw a circle to indicate the head. Then inside that circle, I would like to draw a vertical line and a horizontal line, and draw the jawline with some lines and slanted lines. Alright, so now if you want to, you can add your ears, which I did, and then you will draw two lines underneath the face for the neck. Then I like to draw another vertical line underneath, and then here, this is where I draw the torso, so it's kind of like a rectangle kind of shape or a square shape. So it is basically a horizontal line on top and then some slanted lines going inwards on the side. So like that on the screen, as you guys can see. Then I like to connect the neck to the torso. Then below the torso, I like to draw this kind of like skirt thing, but it's not a skirt. And you're gonna leave two holes for the legs. And now you're gonna draw two circles for the legs. And then underneath, you're going to draw another circle, but it's a little bit smaller. And then you are going to do kind of like a slanted line, but not too slanted, to connect the two circles together. And then underneath, you want to draw two straight lines to finish the legs. But here, I actually kind of ran out of space, but normally I would draw some shoes underneath. You will be able to see how the shoes look later on, but for the arms, I draw a circle for the shoulders, and then I draw another circle underneath for the actual arms, and then underneath I draw this kind of like a square looking type of shape for the hands. So yeah. Now we are moving on to anatomy poses. So more specifically, I'm drawing a sitting pose. So yeah, this is basically going to be the same thing for male bodies, how I draw like anatomy, but here I was drawing a female. And also I did have to use a reference for this because I am still kind of bad at drawing anatomy. So yeah, you might be wondering how is this like how I draw bodies, since if I am like using a reference. Well, I'm just using the reference for how things will look, but I am going to be drawing this obviously just in like how I would draw it, but the reference is just for me to like tell me where the lines go and all of that. Anyways, but I do the same thing. I start off with a head and do the vertical and horizontal lines, and then add the ear, the neck, and all of that. So now I am moving on to the torso. So I try to keep all these shapes kind of the same as how I showed you before. But for anatomy poses, I like to break up things a lot more. So as you can see, for the arm, I broke up a lot and a lot of things. So I did a circle and then another circle, and then I basically connected it randomly. So you guys want, for like, here's like a tip for drawing anatomy. You want to just go in super loose so that it doesn't look too like, I guess like stiff, I guess. And then you guys will be able to do the details later or go in to fix it later. But here, as you guys can see, I am breaking it up. So yeah, and for the hips as well, I was breaking it up. So now I'm just using an eraser, and then I'm going to be going in more like the details, as I said, so that you guys can kind of see how it will look a little bit more. And I'm just basically redrawing the lines, but a lot neater, so that you guys can understand a little bit more. So that is how this one looks. I hope that you guys kind of understand. Anyways, now we are moving on to male bodies. So once again, I start off with a circle. So male bodies is kind of just like female bodies, except in my type of way, or how I like draw it. Basically, you just want to make the lines a lot more visible and not too roundy as female bodies. So yeah, but basically currently it is the same process, but now for the torso, I do a rectangle and then a line, and then underneath there will be a little gap, and then for this, I basically not do a skirt, but I do a line, a horizontal line on top, some slanted lines going inwards, and then I leave again two holes for the legs. Now I am just connecting the neck to the torso, and then I am connecting the torso and the bottom part as well, and then now I'm just drawing the arms and the hands, so it is pretty much kind of like the same process as a female body, except that you can kind of see the lines a lot more clearer and the torso part is a lot more different. So now we are moving to other body types. So basically, before we do talk about this, I just want to say that I think all body types are beautiful and gorgeous. And honestly, I love all body types. They are all super duper pretty. So yeah, I just want you guys to know, if you guys are like a little bit sad about your body or not really liking your body, I just want to remind you guys that your body is beautiful no matter what. And yeah, anyways, with that, let's get on with this tutorial. So basically here I am drawing a more shorter girl. I'm not quite sure if that's kind of counted as like a body type. I think it is. Anyways, so specifically I am drawing a female shorter girl, and yes, so basically it is the same process as the female body, except I make everything a lot shorter and a lot smaller. So as you guys can see, I made the head quite smaller, and as I was saying, you guys can see the shoes later on, and this is what I mean. It is basically just a triangle type of thing, and yeah, so basically the process is completely the same. And if you're making a male shorter body or another type of body, it will basically be the same process, but just male, and you just make everything shorter and smaller. So yeah. And here is the result for all of them. If you guys have any questions, make sure to comment down below and make sure to subscribe, and bye.